This is the Provoked Prawn, and this is a video to talk to you about the SteelSeries Arctis Nova Pro, the wired version, and a problem you might have if you've tried to update the firmware and ended up bricking the DAC. So if you're plugging in the control box with the volume wheel on it, and you found that when you plug it in with a USB connection, SteelSeries GG recommends a firmware update, and you carry out that update, and then you find that it won't turn on anymore and it doesn't work because the update failed for some reason during that process, then I'm going to talk to you about one way to fix it. I've had this happen to my headset, and it was very frustrating because basically I didn't do anything wrong. I didn't turn my PC off. I didn't close the software, but it just failed to update during the process. And then it says that it wants to update again, but when you plug it in, nothing happens. Now you'll see that on the PC on the right-hand side running Windows 11, if I plug it in with a USB connection, it shows the SteelSeries logo and then it disappears and it goes black. The SteelSeries GG software does recognize that I've plugged the DAC in, and it says there's even a little warning on the screen that lets you know that the update has failed, and it then tells you to try it again. But when you click to try again, nothing happens, and it doesn't update, and basically the thing doesn't fill up, and it just sits there doing nothing for forever until you give up and close the software and get frustrated and cry about it. Now, I have found one fix. However, it isn't an easy fix, and I can't guarantee it will work, because I actually managed to test out two different headsets, and it worked on one but not on the other. So on the left-hand side, I have a completely different PC running Windows 10 and SteelSeries GG. And so I'm going to plug the DAC into that. Now, what I found is that during this process, actually plugging that DAC into a completely different PC, you can then update it and update the firmware, and that will fix it. It doesn't work 100% of the time. I've only found that it works 50% of the time out of the two headsets that I've tried, but I think it's worth sharing. Now, I'm going to do a video in the near future, hopefully once I get some more feedback from SteelSeries on this and other ways to fix it. I have tried other things, for example, pressing and holding buttons and plugging it in. I've tried plugging it into multiple different devices. But what you can see is that when you go in and update it, you then have the option to run the firmware and it will work. And I did end up restoring one of the headsets, so it will work perfectly fine. Obviously, if you have a laptop knocking around, or if you can borrow one from a friend, you could potentially download it on that. Here you can see me with a Surface laptop, for example. You can download SteelSeries GG to that and then run it. Now, I will say that I did run it on Windows 10, so that might be the fix. I'm not 100% sure on whether it's a Windows 11 problem or not. Initially, I installed it in Windows 11. Then I tried the fix on Windows 10, and that did work. But whether that's a coincidence, I'm not quite sure. Obviously, this is a bit of a frustrating fix. It might not work for you. It might, but hopefully it'll give you some ideas to try out. But the end result was I managed to get the headset working. I will report back in the near future if anything changes. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Thanks for watching.